everybody. Sorry, there's weird people in the background. I wanted to show you an exercise that you can do for your back and your core. We've done these side reaches before, but this is gonna add a little bit extra because people have been talking about those bat wings they wanna get rid of. So this is gonna get, the bat wing's gonna get your core, it's gonna get that menopause muffin top, whatever it is that you wanna get rid of, okay? So what you're gonna do is you're gonna take one arm and you're gonna reach it all the way towards that opposite hip, and then this arm, that opposite arm, is gonna be reaching overhead. So I'm reaching simultaneously in opposite directions. So as you can see, there's a lot of stretch here. I'm pulling in my core. So there's a difference between letting your core go loose, and you can see, as you know, I had that diastasis recti, my abs will show you when I'm not flexing. So from here, there's a hole. What you wanna do is pull your ribcage together. So that doesn't mean do this, right? It means roll your hips under, pull the ribcage together. So that's the first activation. Activate the core, and then reach, okay? Reach. Reach and reach, and you're gonna find a huge stretch back here. You're getting that arm work. Now I'm gonna do the other side. So first thing, root through the toes, through the heels, roll your pelvis under, activate your core, and reach, okay? This is a great core exercise if you can't get up and down off the floor, if you have knee problems, if you have back problems. You're gonna wanna make sure that you're not straight leg, okay? Do not go straight leg, because look what my hips do. They go out and you totally lose that core strength. So, root your heels, root your toes, roll the pelvis under, flex, okay? Pull that rib cage together, chest up, shoulders back, pull the rib cage, reach in opposite directions. Reach in opposite directions, same thing. Reach in opposite directions. So, you can add this to your workout on the front end or back end. It just depends on what you're trying to accomplish. It's a great warm up, but it's also gonna target your core. So, I suggest tacking this on to the end of your workout. Do 10 sets on each side, so that's 20 total. You're gonna do a set of three, so three rounds, 10 each side, okay? So if you have any questions, let me know. Like I said yesterday, like I've been saying, it's the theme of the week and last week, is just tell me what you wanna see. It's much easier for me to create videos for you if I know what you wanna see instead of me guessing. So if it's core work, if it's lower back work, if it's modifications, if it's modifications for your wrists, for your hands, for your knees, whatever it is, post down below. And then also, if you keep scrolling down, you'll see the workout from Svelte Sunday, which was yesterday, and it's broken up into a warm up and then also your main set. So you can redo that main set as much as you like. I'd kind of think you'd wanna do 3 to 4 sets of that. High intensity, get after that triple threat. And just let me know if you guys have any questions, and have an amazing day. Hopefully the weather is as nice where you are as it is here. All right, see ya.